Hello everyone, how are you children and my dear teachers? What you are observing here, different kinds of food materials, mouth-watering dishes you are observing here. Anyway, what is your favorite food? Yes. Everybody has their own interest. Why do you like it? Is only favorite food sufficient for you? Why? You like one dish every day, do you eat that one only, or is that enough for you to survive or live? Your favorite food is enough for you. What do you eat every day? Do you eat them? Why do you eat them? Do we need energy when we sleep? You have to think the answers for all these questions and write in your notebook. Okay? And discuss with your, ask your parents or friends, whomever reach, you can reach out. Okay? Every day we are eating different kinds of food items, isn't it? So, why do we eat them? For the sake of energy, for doing different kind of activities, we are eating them. When we need energy generally, for doing all kinds of activities, for writing, running, sleeping, do we really need energy for sleeping? At the time of sleeping, we are not performing any activity. Then that time also, do we need energy? Yes, we need energy at time of sleeping also, because internal organs like our heart, lungs, circulatory system, respiratory system, different kinds of systems are working internally even though we are sleeping. To perform those activities, our body requires energy. But when compared to doing external actions like working in the fields or game at the time of gaming, we require more energy when compared to sleeping. Okay? So why should we eat? Means we, to get energy, we are eating the food. How the food can, after taking the food, immediately it is converted to energy? Means no, it is not happens. That food must be oxidized with oxygen, later it is converted into energy, then only we can perform different activities. So children, today we are going to discuss about the food components. Okay. From this lesson, what you are going to learn, what are the learning outcomes you are going to get? Identifies the food components present in food. Daily we are eating different kinds of food items. What are the food components present in it? We are going to see now. Explains the main food components of food. Conducts experiments that how to find the component of a food. Analyzes that which is good for health. These are all learning outcomes achieved by you after completion of this lesson. Before going to enter into our lesson, I would like to ask some more questions. Think about it and try to write the answers for those and discuss with your elders. Suppose if you don't get food for lunch in the school time or at our home, how do you feel? Are you active or are you happy? You can, what is your feeling? We feel hungry, isn't it? If you don't get anything for more than a day, how will you feel? Even in a day complete, in a complete day, you could not eat anything. You couldn't eat. So what will happen to you? If you don't get food for many days, what will happen? Means, if you are the children, you works very hard when compared to the elders. That means you play all the time and do the activities very fastly. So that is why you requires more energy when compared to elders. So for the long time, there are no energy storages in your body. So that is why every day the energy will be used up in your body. So if the energy storage is not present in your body, ultimately if you don't take food for many days, what happens? Your body becomes lean. You becomes lean. And it leads to the malnutritious diseases also. You can see what is malnutritious diseases in later classes. If for many days you can't eat, you are not able to eat the food, means you will get some symptomatic diseases. So we should not skip the lunch or dinner for many days. What are the components present in food? What happens to us if if you do not take food for many days? I told you already. In elders, it do not create any malnutritious disease. But if you take the children, they severely, if for many days, if they don't take food for many days, they definitely get the malnutritious disease. Of all the food items eaten by you today, do you like chocolates and biscuits? Do you find the nutrient values on it? Generally, children are very interested in eating biscuits and chocolates. Have you ever seen the components of the food given on the wrapper of that biscuit packet or chocolate packet, chocolate wrapper? See, next time observe the food components on the wrappers of the food items like wheat flour, like sugar, whatever the food packets brought by you or parents at your home, observe the components on it. Then you will find what are the components of food we are eating. Let us observe the components given on the food items. I will show some food items here. See the nutrition information. On every food packet, on every food wrapper, definitely they give the nutrition value or nutrition information like this. Here carbohydrates are 80.7 grams for 100. This is the product of 100 grams given here. Proteins are 9 grams. Sugars are 23 grams. Fat is 8.3 grams. In fats, saturated and monosaturated fatty acids. Like that, here also polyunsaturated fatty acids, cholesterol zero, energy. If we eat the complete packet, how much energy we will get also given here. So what are the main food items you have observed? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats. In fats there are different poly, mono, unsaturated fatty acids information is given here. Let us observe another one food packet. This is gulab jamun food packet. Earlier we have seen the rusk packet, written here rusk. This is gulab jamun packet. Here the total calories we, if we eat the complete material present in this packet, means we can get 390 kilocalories of energy. How much proteins are present? 14 grams. Carbohydrates 80 grams, added sugar 3, fat 10.4, saturated fat, MUFA, trans fat, cholesterol, fiber, sodium. Sodium is a mineral. These are all the components of the food items given here on the gulab jamun packet. And if we want to see the biscuit wrapper, this is the Good Day biscuit wrapper. You can observe here the nutrition values of food components. Carbohydrates, of which sugars प्रोटीन 7 ग्राम्स, कार्बोहाइड्रेट 67 ग्राम्स, फैट 24 ग्राम्स, सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स, मोनो सैचुरेटेड एंड पॉली अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स, कोलेस्ट्रॉल, टोटल एनर्जी, हाउ मच एनर्जी वी कैन गेट फ्रॉम दिस पैकेट इज गिवन हियर, दैट इज 512 किलो कैलोरीज ऑफ एनर्जी. दिस इज द कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ फूड आइटम. दिस फूड आइटम, वॉट दिस फूड आइटम कंटेन, वी कैन गेट द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम हियर. ओके, आई विल शो यू अनदर वन. दिस इज द बॉक्स ऑफ किमिया डेज. हियर द न्यूट्रिशन इंफॉर्मेशन गिवेन ऑन दिस बॉक्स, दैट इज एनर्जी 285 कैलोरीज एंड कंप्लीट बॉक्स. इफ यू ईट दिस कंप्लीट बॉक्स, वी कैन गेट दिस मच ऑफ एनर्जी. एक्चुअली फॉर 100 ग्राम्स, इफ यू ईट 100 ग्राम्स ऑफ किमिया डेट्स, वी कैन गेट 285 कैलोरीज ऑफ एनर्जी. हाउ मच वाटर हियर इन दिस फ्रूट्स, 31 ग्राम्स, प्रोटीन्स 1.61 ग्राम्स, कार्बोहाइड्रेट 63.77, फैट 0.54, फाइबर 1.64, सोडियम 17 mg/mg. जर ग्राम्स इज फ्रॉम हियर सोडियम टू मिलीग्राम्स, कैल्शियम 43 mg. Here phosphorus 50 mg, potassium 697 mg, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin B, riboflavin, niacin, folic acid, iron, zinc. These are all the vitamins. And from sodium, calcium, phosphorus, these are all minerals. You have seen different four kinds of food reports and the nutrition value given on that. So children, try at your home, try to observe the food wrappers brought by your parents and what are the food components present in it. Mainly what we are observed in that food packets, what are the essential components of food means carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, water and fiber. In the Kimira dates packet, we have observed here the vitamins and minerals. If we take the rusk packet, you are observing energy, proteins, fat and like that. If we observe this biscuits, here also fatty acids, carbohydrates and like that. Here if you observe here different carbohydrates, proteins, some fatty acids and also sodium, fiber given like that. Means here carbohydrates, proteins, fats are in every food component. They are present in every food component. But in some food items, their number will be, their quantity will be more. In some food items, their quantity will be less. If we take the fruits, in fruits mainly, the composition is different. Vitamins and minerals we have seen. Water also is there. In Kimia fruits, water percentage is more when compared to other. If we see that gulab jamun packet, there is in that composition they give in the fibers also. Like that, these are the main food components which we have in our food items. In whatever we are eating in our day-to-day life, that food items definitely contains more than these food components. Okay, try and observe at your home. Okay. How do we find the component of a food? How do we know this food item especially contains starch, or this food item especially contain protein? For the especially children has to eat the protein contained food for their growth. So how can we find the food item whether it has carbohydrate or protein or it has fat? For that we have some tests to identify the starch present in food items and proteins also. So I will show you the test for starch and with the help of a video. In this video, I will show you how to test the presence of starch in food items. Here what we need, iodine solution is need, and we took different kinds of food items here, that is a potato, starch flour, lemon, cooked rice, Bengal gram dal flour, and also the raw banana. I am adding the iodine solution with the help of dropper, keeping it on every food items. 2 drops are added to, 2-3 drops are added to each and every food item. We will see what will happen. These are the my students from 7th class. We added to Bengal gram dal flour. Bengal gram dal flour and raw banana. See what are the changes observed here. If the food item gets dark, or the color of the food item changes to bluish black color, so it is it has the starch in it. The color of potato changed, in the rice flour also changed. See, the lemon color does not change. The iodine color remained on its same. What is the color of iodine? Yellowish brown color. It is same on the lemon. If you observe the cooked rice, it is also changed to bluish black color. And that is Bengal gram dal. That flour, that is also changed. And we observe the raw banana, the color of it also changed to bluish black. That means these all items have the carbohydrates except lemon. Okay. Children, you have seen that if the food item contains starch, if we tested it with iodine solution, that food item color will be changed to bluish black. That indicates that that food item has the starch in it. Okay, you can do this experiment at your home. Try this. Okay. Next, I want to show you the protein test. Which food items contain protein in it? For this, I will show you one experiment performed by me with my students. See here. Copper sulfate pellets and sodium hydroxide pellets. I made the copper sulfate into as a copper sulfate solution. Two percentage copper sulfate solution, and I added sodium hydroxide pellets to water and made as a sodium hydroxide solution. I have to make it 10% sodium hydroxide solution. If we want to test the proteins in a food item, we have to make the food item into liquid form. So I am adding the Bengal gram flour solution, water. Here we are adding the water to sugar crystals also. So we are making both these items as solution. Later we will test those Bengal gram dal flour solution and also sugar solution with those two chemicals. Okay, they are making as a solution. solution is ready. Yes. First, they are adding a few drops of copper sulfate solution to the sugar solution, and here Bengal gram dal flour solution. You have to stir it well. Copper sulfate solution should be mixed with that food solution. And secondly, we are adding the sodium hydroxide solution to both the solutions. Those two solutions are in blue color now. See what will happen after adding the sodium hydroxide solution to it. Observe the color of those two solutions. Which solution has the purple color? That solution contains proteins. This is the Bengal gram dal flour solution and this is sugar solution. Which solution has the purple color in it? Observe them carefully. What is the color of this and what is the color of this? This is blue and this is purple. So that is why Bengal gram dal flour solution has the proteins in it. So mostly all the pulses contains proteins in it. Okay, we have to. That is why government is supplying in the that is that means in the midday meals we are giving the dal curry for students day by day for their growth. That is essential. Proteins are the very important food component for the growth. Here see the summary what we have learnt up to yet. Components of food. Identifying the components present on the food wrappers used by us in our day to day life. How to test the presence of starch. How to identify the presence of proteins in food. What kind of food we have to eat. We have to eat only one food item or different kinds of food items. We have to eat different kinds of, that means the food which has carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, all kinds of food components should be present which we are taking daily. Okay, here is the evaluation. In the evaluation, what are the main, you have to write the answers for these questions. What are the main components of food? What is the procedure to be followed to test the presence of proteins in food? What is the chemical should be used to test the presence of starch? What are the materials used to find the presence of proteins in food? Which kind of food items do you take in your daily life? These are all the questions children try to answer. And if you don't get the answer, refer the textbook once and also see this lesson again. You will definitely answer these questions. Thank you everyone. Thank you children and teachers. Thanks for the patient listening. I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye.